to share from my heart what I feel from the Lord tonight.
Les voy a compartir lo que siento en mi corazón.
The topic that I was going to speak on, I was going to continue to teach on communication tonight.
El tema que iba a hablar era de comunicación.
And I took a moment while I was preparing the lesson. I said, God, surely I don't have to teach about communication with you.
Antes de cuando estaba estudiando por este mensaje, dije, Señor, no tengo que enseñar de comunicación contigo.
Surely the congregation has heard so much about prayer that I could focus on some other areas regarding communication.
De seguro la iglesia ya ha oído bastante de la oración y puedo enfocarme en otras cosas de comunicación.
And tonight God is knocking on my heart, and I'm wanting to just flow with Him tonight.
Y hoy el Señor está tocando en mi corazón y quiero fluir con Él.
You see, with our communication with our spouses, with our family, with our friends, with our brothers and sisters,
la comunicación con nuestra esposa, esposo, nuestros hermanos,
if we don't have our communication with the Lord,
si no tenemos comunicación con el Señor,
we don't have a relationship with Him,
no tenemos relación con Él,
if we're not praying,
si no estamos orando,
not reading our word,
no estamos leyendo la palabra,
every other relationship that we have is going to fall short.
Toda la otra relación que tenemos no se va a cumplir.
We started off this series talking about the rock, talking about Christ being the foundation of all that we do.
Comenzamos esta serie de que hablando que Jesús es la fundación, es la roca.
I want you to take a moment right now and close your eyes.
Tome unos momentos, cierre sus ojos.
I want you to think about the beginning of your day.
Piense del comienzo de su día.
From the moment you woke up.
Desde que se levantó.
Did the alarm go off? Did you rush to get ready for work?
Sonó la alarma, se fue rápidamente para irse al trabajo.
Did your parents wake you up for school?
Sus padres lo levantaron para ir a la escuela.
What time today did you seek first the kingdom of God?
¿A qué tiempo buscaste el reino de los cielos?
What time today did we spend in God's word?
¿Qué tiempo hoy nos metimos en la palabra de Dios?
Did we talk to Him today?
¿Hablamos con Él hoy?
Or did we come into the house, this house?
¿O llegamos a esta casa?
And this was the first time that we tried to connect with Him.
Y era la primera vez que tratamos de hablar con Él.
We could go through hours and hours and hours of teaching on family, on all of these things.
Podemos enseñar horas y horas y horas en la familia.
But if we don't get this one thing right,
pero si no entendemos esta cosa,
it'll just be psychology.
Simplemente va a ser psicología.
It'll turn into man-made studies and different things that you could get on a seminar on YouTube.
Simplemente sería enseñanzas de hombre.
You could throw a little scripture in and talk about emotional awareness and all of these things, but without the power of prayer and the power of the Holy Ghost,
puede hablar de la comunicación, pero si no hay el poder del Espíritu Santo,
you will never be able to overcome the challenges that you are facing right now.
Nunca va a poder vencer los problemas que usted tiene hoy.
Lift your hands right now.
Levante sus manos.
Father, Lord, you are wanting to rush through this place right now.
Padre, ¿quieres fluir en este lugar?
Lord, you are not one to condemn.
No eres uno para condenar.
But you are one to convict.
Pero tú sí eres alguien que da convicción.
And Lord, I am convicted right now.
Y yo estoy, tengo convicción.
And I pray today, Father, that you would just flow through this place and touch every individual where they're at right now.
Y oro, Señor, que fluyas en este lugar y toca a cada persona ahí donde ellos están.
Can we just press just a little deeper right now?
Podemos empujar un poco más profundo.
If you don't know what to say right now, just God, I need you.
Si no sabe qué decir, dígale, Señor, te necesito.
Lord, I need your help right now.
Necesito tu ayuda, Señor.
I know I didn't call out for you this morning, but God, I understand my desperate need of you right now.
Yo sé que no clamé hacia ti en la mañana, pero sé que te necesito ahorita.
In the name of Jesus.
En el nombre de Jesús.
In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. There's times when where we can get very excited about the things of God.
Hay tiempos que nos podemos emocionar de las cosas de Dios.
To where we could go from emotional high to emotional high.
Podemos de ir de emoción a emoción.
I don't know about you, but I love the feeling of the Lord just rushing over me and tears flowing through my eyes. I love those mountaintop experiences.
No sé de usted, pero a mí me encanta, me gusta cuando el Señor me toca y me siento la presencia de él.
Don't even act like you don't love it.
No actúe como si usted no lo ama.
We love feeling the Lord.
Amamos sentir al Señor.
He made us emotional creatures.
Él nos hizo emocional.
But what do we do when we stop feeling him?
Pero ¿qué hacemos cuando no lo sentimos?
What do we do when you don't hear his voice anymore?
¿Qué haces cuando no oyes su voz?
What do you do?
¿Qué haces?
What are you doing right now?
¿Qué estás haciendo ahorita?
There's almost half of you in here that haven't been hearing his voice.
Hay de la mitad de ustedes que no están oyendo su voz.
There's some of you that have been frustrated with God.
Hay uno de ustedes que están frustrados con el Señor.
And you're attributing it to the situation that you're in right now.
Y piensas que es el problema que estás metido.
But God's been saying, I've been here.
Pero el Señor está diciendo, aquí estoy.
I've been here the whole time.
Aquí he estado todo el tiempo.
Lift your hands again.
Levante sus manos.
God's trying to break away right now.
El Señor quiere quebrantar.
Some of the scales that we've put up of tradition.
Quebrantar la tradición.
He's trying to break down the walls of our mind right now, the things that we've justified over and over and over again.
Quiere quebrantar las cosas de nuestras mentes que nosotros justificamos cada vez, tiempo tras tiempo.
The reasons why you've justified not praying.
Las razones porque lo justificas no orando.
Why you've justified not fasting.
Justificas no ayunando.
Why you've justified not worshiping at the altar.
Justificas no adorando en el altar.
Why you've justified all the hard work that you do, that there's some things that you could get away with.
Justificas todo el trabajo que tú haces que no tienes que hacer algunas cosas.
Raise your hands, Father.
Levante sus manos.
I pray right now by the authority of your word that you would purge right now, God. Purge us right now, Father. Let the fire of the Holy Ghost fall in this place right now. By the authority of your word, God, we pray, Lord, that you would cut away everything, God, everything that would keep us from you. Right now, Jesus, pluck up the roots, God, that we have allowed to grow. Lord, don't just cut, but pluck up the roots, God, that we have allowed to grow in our lives, Lord. Pull out the tares, God. We pray today. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Oh God, pray. Oh, Jesus. Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
En el nombre de Jesús.
God, we just want to serve you, Lord.
Simplemente te queremos servir,
we
Señor.
We just want to honor you today.
Te queremos honrar.
Is that your heart's desire today?
¿Es el deseo de tu corazón hoy?
Jesus, I desire
Te deseo a ti, Jesús.
I desire you, Lord.
Te deseo a ti, Señor.
When our vertical communication is addressed,
cuando nuestra comunicación vertical,
things start to shift with the way you start speaking.
Cosas empiezan a cambiar lo que usted habla.
We talked about the power, the words have the power of death and life. It's in the tongue.
Hablamos de que las palabras tienen el poder de la muerte y de la vida.
And when we're speaking to our spouses, when we're speaking to our brothers or sisters,
cuando estamos hablando con nuestra pareja, con nuestros hermanos o hermanas,
what we say and what we do,
lo que decimos o hacemos,
will either help them grow,
nos va a hacer crecer,
or we'll start cutting them down,
nos va a cortar hacia abajo.
And you see, the thing is that when we allow flesh to build up in our lives,
la cosa es cuando dejamos la carne que crezca,
when we choose to not pray, when we choose to not read our word,
cuando escogemos no orar o no leer la palabra,
we call these moments common.
Llamamos estos momentos común.
And we, you know, we could be in a move of God right now.
Podemos estar en un mover del Espíritu Santo.
We could be joking, we could be laughing, we could be talking about other people while God is moving in this place.
Nos podemos estar riendo, hablando de otras personas mientras el Señor se está moviendo en este lugar.
And you see, it's a dangerous place to be. I was there as a young person. I remember getting called out by Bishop when I was sitting in the back chatting with my friends.
Es algo muy peligroso estar en ese lugar. Yo me acuerdo que el obispo me llamó la atención cuando yo era joven.
And I don't need to do that because you know who you are right now.
Y no necesito hacer eso porque ustedes saben quiénes son.
But I remember the conviction that I felt when Bishop would do that.
Pero yo me acuerdo la convicción que yo sentía cuando el obispo hacía eso.
I remember that moment of, it was like a dagger to the heart. Has anyone felt that conviction from the Lord before?
Me recuerdo ese momento, era como un dolor en mi corazón.
You see, there's a difference between condemnation and conviction.
Hay una diferencia de la condenación y la convicción.
Condemnation is a weight.
Condenación es una pesada.
Conviction is more like a little stab.
La convicción es como un picar.
It pricks your heart.
Te pica el corazón.
Gets you right where you need it.
Te duele donde lo necesitas.
Anyways, back to the power of words. I was doing something right there, I promise.
El poder de las palabras.
But to the power of words right now, when you're not addressing your communication with God, and if you're not hearing His voice, get in His Word, because He's speaking through His Word.
Si no estás oyendo la voz de Él, métete en la palabra de Dios, porque te está hablando a través de su palabra.
But my communication with my spouse starts to crumble a little bit.
Pero la comunicación con mi esposa se empieza a bajar un poco.
When I'm not communicating with God.
Cuando no estoy hablando con el Señor.
I'm not able to serve her the way that I am called to serve her.
No puedo servirle como el Señor me ha llamado a servirle.
And where I'm at right now, if I'm not communicating with God, I'm not able to serve you correctly.
Y ahorita donde yo estoy, si no estaba hablando con el Señor, no les puedo servir a ustedes correctamente.
And so think about your area of influence. Everyone is a leader here.
Piense de su lugar que tiene influencia usted. Cada uno de ustedes es un líder.
You may be leading your dog, but you're a leader.
A lo mejor usted es un líder de su perro, pero usted es un líder.
And if you have a cat, you should kill it.
Si tiene gato, mátelo.
I'm sorry. I repent. That was flesh. I promise. But you are leading in some type of capacity.
Usted es un líder de algo.
You know that our children lead each other?
¿Saben que nuestros niños se dan, dirigen ellos mismos?
Some of these guys pray more than us.
Algunos de ellos oran más que algunos de nosotros.
They're using peer pressure to say, hey, you want to go pray?
Le dicen uno al otro, ¿quieres orar?
But you see, they're communicating with each other.
Pero se están hablando ellos mismos.
And leading each other to make a good choice, amen?
Se están llevando para hacer buenas decisiones.
But whenever we are not praying and whenever we're not connecting to the source, my relationship with my brother starts to I start to say things that don't edify him.
Cuando no estoy orando, empiezo a decir algunas cosas que no edifica a mi hermano.
You know, the word says that I'm supposed to speak words that edify my brother.
La palabra dice que tengo que usar palabras para edificar mi hermano.
Words that are not going to cut him down, but to lift him up.
Palabras que no lo van a cortar hacia abajo, pero sino que lo van a levantar.
You know, it even talks about jesting in the Bible. Do you guys know what that is?
Habla de gestos.
Talks about jesting with each other. It talks about some of the smack talk that a lot of us are so comfortable with.
Está hablando
speaking.
De gestos, de bromas, de bromeando con uno al otro.
And it talks against that.
Y habla contra ello.
That's convicting.
Eso me trae convicción.
You know how much we like to give each other a hard time?
¿Sabe cuánto nos gusta darle a echarle carrilla al otro?
You know why we do that?
¿Sabes por qué hacemos eso?
Because we're carnal.
Porque somos carnales.
We do that because we're carnal.
Hacemos eso porque somos carnales.
Think about it.
Piense de eso.
Are you honoring God when you're on the basketball court?
Está honrando al Señor cuando anda jugando.
Talking trash, breaking ankles.
Hablando cosas, diciendo cosas.
Hey, I just talked trash last Sunday.
Yo hablé cosas el otro domingo.
Playing soccer with all the young people.
Jugando fútbol con los jóvenes.
I want to talk trash right now, but I'm not going to because it would go against what I'm saying.
Quiero bromear ahorita, pero no lo voy a hacer porque.
But you see, that's the fruit of the spirit, temperance.
Eso es el fruto del espíritu, paciencia.
But that's carnality, you guys.
Pero esa es la carne.
If you go through Ephesians chapter 4,
si se mete en Efesios 4.
My goodness, it just breaks it down. It just starts cutting it apart. So we talk about unity.
Lo habla en ese capítulo, habla de todo. Hablamos de la unidad.
We want to have, you know, the unity of faith, unity in the spirit.
Unidad del espíritu, unidad de la fe.
And it goes down the line in Ephesians.
Y se mete ahí en Efesios.
One Lord, one faith, one baptism.
Un Señor, un bautismo.
We have the fivefold ministry there. Go ahead. You go there right now. You can see it.
Tenemos el ministerio.
You're doing all right, man. But you start going down. It starts to address the way that we talk.
Empieza a hablar de la manera de cómo hablamos.
It says, I want to steal your Bible, man. I'm going to have to pull it up here. Can we pull up Ephesians 4?
Efesios 4.
Why don't you go there with me?
Ve ahí conmigo.
Ephesians chapter 4.
Efesios 4.
I'm just flowing tonight, guys.
Simplemente estoy fluyendo hoy.
Forgive me about the cat comment.
Perdóneme de lo que dije del gato.
Ephesians, hey, I don't know about you. If you've been, I'm praying for Brother Stan.
Yo estoy hablando para el hermano
Stan. I told him right when he got off of the platform, I said, bro, those are dangerous waters you're swimming in right now.
Yo le dije al hermano, esas son aguas peligrosas que se están metiendo.
There's some things you could just not talk about.
Hay algunas cosas que no tiene que hablar.
Yes, she is. Ephesians chapter 4, verse number 22. Let's start there.
Efesios 4 y 22.
Actually, why don't we go up, let's go up to verse number 18. I'm sorry.
Al versículo 18.
It says, having the understanding darkened, being alienated from the life of God through the ignorance that is in them because of the blindness of their heart. This is talking about Gentiles.
Okay. 18, teniendo el entendimiento entembrecido, ajenos de la vida de Dios para ignorancia que en ellos hay para la dureza de su corazón.
Saying that Gentiles walk in the vanity of their mind.
Diciendo que los gentiles hablan en la vanidad de su mente.
Verse number 19. Who being past feeling have given themselves over unto lasciviousness to work all uncleanness. Who knows what lasciviousness means?
19, los cuales después que perdieron toda sensibilidad se entregaron a la lascivia para cometer con avidez toda clase de impureza. ¿Quién sabe qué es lascivia?
Lasciviousness is, I would say, lust, sexual impurity, okay?
Lascivia es la impureza sexual.
It says, lasciviousness to work all uncleanness with greediness. And verse 20 says, but ye have not so learned Christ.
Versículo 20 dice, mas vosotros no habéis aprendido así a Cristo.
If so be that ye have heard him, and have taught by him, as the truth is in Jesus.
Si en verdad le habéis oído, y habéis sido por él enseñados, conforme la verdad que está en Jesús.
Little Bible study thing, anytime you see the colon there, go back to verse, I think, 21, right? Yeah, anytime you see the colon in there, you know that this is the next sentence is a part of this verse, okay?
Cuando ve esto en la Biblia, usted sabe, cuando se terminan con esto, usted sabe que el siguiente verso es parte de este verso.
Verse 22 says that ye put off, here we go.
Verso 22 dice,
put off concerning the former conversation, the old man which is corrupt, according to the deceitful lusts.
En cuanto a la pasada manera de vivir, despojaos del viejo hombre que está viciado conforme a los deseos engañosos.
Verse 23, and be renewed in what? The spirit of your mind.
Y renovaos en el espíritu de vuestra mente.
And that ye put on the new man, which after God is created in righteousness and true holiness.
Y vestíos del nuevo hombre, criado según Dios en la justicia y santidad de la verdad.
Wherefore, putting away lying,
por cual desechando la mentira,
some lying, a little bit of lying,
alguna mentira, poca mentira,
put away lying,
desechar toda mentira,
speak every man truth with his neighbor.
Hablad verdad cada uno con su prójimo.
For we are members one of another.
Porque somos miembros los unos de los otros.
Could you close your eyes right now?
Cierre sus ojos.
Could you take an account of the words that you spoke today?
Piense de las palabras que usted habló hoy.
Could you take an account of anything that you may have exaggerated on?
Haga cuentas de lo que usted a lo mejor,
any excuses you made that were lies?
Hizo excusas o mentiras que dijo?
Any habits that we've made?
O algunos hábitos que ha hecho?
That produce lie after lie after lie?
Que producen mentira tras mentira?
Search us, Lord. 26, be ye angry and sin not. Let not the sun go down upon your wrath.
Airaos, pero no pequéis. No se ponga el sol sobre vuestro enojo.
Neither give place to the devil.
Ni deis lugar al diablo.
Let him that stole steal no more, but rather let him labor, working with his hands the things which is good, that he may have to give to him that needeth.
El que hurtaba no hurte más, sino trabaje, haciendo con sus manos lo que es bueno, para que tenga que compartir con lo que padece necesidad.
Here we go again. Let no corrupt communication proceed out of your mouth.
Otra vez, ninguna palabra corrompida salga de vuestra boca.
Out of your mouth.
De su boca,
out of your hands,
de sus manos,
on the internet,
en la red.
Renew the spirit of our mind.
Renueva el espíritu de nuestra mente.
Renew our hearts, renew our mind tonight. Could you raise your hands?
Renueve nuestra mente, nuestro corazón. Levante sus manos.
Father, your word is perfect. Your word is true.
Tu palabra es perfecta y verdad, Señor.
I pray today, Father, that you would speak. I'm not doing it justice, Father, but your spirit is speaking. And I pray, Father, that you would flow through this place.
Tu espíritu está hablando, Señor. Fluye en este lugar.
In the name of Jesus.
El nombre de Jesús.
Let no corrupt communication proceed out of your mouth, but that which is good to use of edifying that it may minister grace unto the hearers.
Ninguna palabra corrompida salga de vuestra boca, sino lo que sea buena para la necesaria edificación, a fin de dar gracia a los oyentes.
Go down to 32. It says, "Be kind one to another, tender-hearted, forgiving one another, even as God for Christ's sake hath forgiven you."
Verso 32, antes de ser benignos unos con otros, misericordiosos, perdonaos unos a otros, como Dios también os perdonó a vosotros en Cristo.
Isn't it interesting how whenever we learn something in God's word,
que no es interesante cuando aprendemos algo en la palabra de Dios,
and don't apply it,
y no lo aplicamos,
we're literally sinning against that word that we now know.
Estamos pecando contra la palabra que aprendimos.
When you know to do good,
cuando usted sabe hacerlo bien,
when you have been given commandments in God's word,
cuando les ha dado mandamientos en la palabra de Dios,
and we don't do it,
y no lo haces,
we're sinning against God.
Estamos pecando contra Dios.
That's such a hard pill to swallow.
Es algo muy difícil.
I want you to think about that for a moment.
Piense de eso.
Every teaching that you've heard,
cada enseñanza que ha aprendido,
every word that you've read in the Bible,
cada palabra que ha leído en la palabra,
the Bible says that they will know that we're his disciples if we love one another and if we keep his commandments.
La palabra dice que la gente sabrá que somos sus discípulos si enseñamos amor y seguimos sus mandamientos.
So we'll be known as his disciples through our love, but to love him, we are to keep his commandments.
Vamos a ser conocidos como sus discípulos en amando a uno otro, pero nos van a conocer en siguiendo sus mandamientos.
So the commandments are more than the Ten Commandments.
Los mandamientos son más que los 10 mandamientos.
But the main ones are love God.
Los más importantes son ama al Señor,
and love others,
ama a otros,
as thyself,
como a uno mismo.
And so, I don't know about you, but sometimes I will read the word and I'll wish I hadn't read that.
Yo no sé de usted, pero a veces yo leo la palabra y me gustaría que no la haga leyera.
Or I'll forget that I read that.
O sea, me olvidó que lo leí.
I was, you guys have heard me talk about the, I'm losing right now, the objectives that we're working on as a church body, and one of them is unity, which is a massive objective that we have.
Me han oído hablar de los objetivos que estamos enseñando aquí en la iglesia. Algunos de ellos es la unidad, que es algo muy grande.
And I think I was a little premature with bringing unity as an objective.
Yo creo que lo traje muy pronto el objetivo de la unidad.
Because after I researched everything that goes into unity,
porque después de lo que estudié todo lo que se mete en la unidad,
it's a lot of work.
Es mucho trabajo.
It's a lot of work for the church to be unified.
Es bastante trabajo para que la iglesia esté unida.
It's a lot of work for us to be unified.
Es mucho trabajo para nosotros para estar unidos.
You know that everything that we just read there in Ephesians 4 are the guidelines for unity.
Todo lo que hemos leído en Efesios 4 son las guías para la unidad.
Some of you are not playing basketball at our church picnic now.
Algunos de ustedes ya no van a jugar baloncesto en las comidas que hacemos.
But these are challenges that we have when it comes to communication.
Son luchas que enfrentamos cuando estamos hablando de la comunicación.
I want to talk to the young people for a second.
Yo quiero hablarle a los jóvenes por un momento.
Has anyone listened to the way that they talk sometimes?
¿Han oído cómo hablan los jóvenes?
You know, I'm not a hellfire brimstone preacher all the time.
Yo no predico del infierno todo el tiempo.
You guys, can I just talk to you young people for a moment?
¿Puedo hablarle a ustedes jóvenes por un momento?
Sarcasm has a lot of truth to it.
A veces cuando uno bromea tiene mucha verdad atrás de ello.
And when you guys, and this is for adults too, I could be sarcastic.
Es también para los adultos, yo también puedo bromear.
And it's something I need to work on.
a lo que yo tengo que trabajar.
But a lot of times we make jokes or talk to each other.
Muchas las veces hacemos chistes o hablamos algunos a los otros.
And we tend to say things that we say as a joke, but the truth is that we really mean what we're saying.
Decimos a veces algunas cosas que decimos que es un chiste, pero a veces hay verdad a través de eso.
And there's, I don't know if you know this, but depression is running greater than ever before in history right now.
No sé si lo conocen, pero la depresión es muy grande en estos tiempos.
And a lot of it is because of the false image that's put on social media.
Pero bastante de eso es por la imagen falsa que está en la red.
The communication that's constantly being put in front of you.
La comunicación que está bastante o mucho de las veces a frente de usted.
And a lot of times we look at that, we compare ourselves to it.
Muchas las veces miramos eso y nos comparamos.
And then we realize, ladies, that we're not a size 2 bikini.
Y nos damos cuenta que no somos de la medida 2.
I don't even know if I'm saying sizes right.
No sé si es la medida correcta.
But we realize that we don't look like an airbrushed model.
Pero nos damos
cuenta
que no somos modelos.
I know none of you look like those six-pack guys. Maybe besides someone here. But social media is constantly communicating, just like the radio frequencies are right now.
La media social se está comunicando con nosotros.
They're communicating something that many times will never be able to achieve. Go ahead and switch the mic out. And so when it comes to sarcasm, young people, with this scripture, and I'm asking you to do this as your pastor, is I'm asking you to speak edifying words to each other and correct the way that you guys make fun of each other.
Cuando ustedes hablan del sarcasmo, cuando se bromean algunos a los otros, pido que se corrijan.
The way that you talk down to each other.
Como se habla a algunos a los otros.
The way that you compare yourselves to each other.
Como se comparan unos a los otros.
This applies to adults too.
También a los adultos.
It says to look at your brother greater than you.
Dice que mire a tu hermano más grande que tú.
And so I'm just challenging you to do that.
Le estoy retando que hagan eso.
Would you stand with me today?
Póngase de pie conmigo.
I want us to just pray over a few things right now.
Quiero que oremos por a través de algunas cosas, por unas cosas.
I want us to pray over our families.
Quiero que oremos por nuestras familias.
I want us to pray over the members of this church.
Orar de los miembros de esta iglesia.
There are several people that are in the hospital right now.
Hay bastantes personas en el hospital.
Our bishop is in Mexico speaking right now.
Nuestro obispo está en México predicando.
And I just want to take a few moments to pray.
Quiero tomar algunos momentos para orar.
I would like us to get out of our seats for a moment and take, we have 10 minutes.
Me gustaría que saliéramos de nuestros asientos.
I'd like for us to take a moment right now to pray together as a body.
Me gustaría que tomemos un tiempo para orar como un cuerpo.
A lot of times we get so self-absorbed with our own situations, our own things that are going on.
A veces somos muy egoístas en nuestras vidas, en lo que nos está pasando.
We don't realize.
No nos damos cuenta.
That someone right next to us could be going through one of the worst times of their life.
Que hay alguien al lado de nosotros que puede estar batallando una lucha muy grande en su vida.
And this is just awareness that we need to have in the spirit.
Tenemos que darnos cuenta en el espíritu.
But also just awareness in general.
Pero también saber esto, conocer esto en general.
To get our minds off of ourselves and on other people.
Para no pensar de solo nosotros mismos, pero de otras personas.
And so could we just get out of our seats for a moment? I want to put the prayer music on right now.
¿Podemos salir de nuestros asientos ahorita?
And I just want to lead us in prayer for a little bit and let the Lord just lead us.
Y quiero orar y que el Señor nos guíe.
It's been different. This is different for me, church. I had like a 12-page message today.
Es algo diferente. Tenía un mensaje de muy largo.
But I'm asking that you commit today to address how your day is going to start tomorrow.
Haga un pacto de cómo su día va a comenzar mañana.
Address how you're going to begin your day tomorrow.
¿Cómo va a comenzar su día mañana?
You put the prayer music on. Can we just raise our hands, kneel, pray, sit?
Levante sus manos, póngase cómodo.
And just for the next few moments, can we just commit right now?
Podemos hacer un pacto.
In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Go ahead, church, you pray.
Ore, iglesia.